scones, the perfect accompaniment to a cup of coffee. They first originated in Scotland around the 1500s, and today there are three main types: an Irish scone, which usually contains sultanas, which are similar to currants or raisins. You have a British scone, which can be sweet or savory, and usually contains raisins, currants, cheese, or dates. There's also a round British scone that looks more like an American biscuit. You also have the griddle scone, which is cooked on a griddle and is more common in New Zealand. And there are also other varieties of scones, depending on the country and location. There's a fruit scone, which is just a plain scone with fruit in it. There's a drop scone, which is similar to a griddle scone, except you drop batter onto the pan or the griddle. And then you also have a lemonade scone, which has no butter or milk and is made with lemonade and cream instead. And then if we want to get down to the science of the scones, you have to get down to the ingredients. One of the main ingredients is baking powder, which contains an alkaline component, baking soda, and an acidic salt, which is cream of tartar. They're both suspended in an inert starch. When the steam from the butter comes in contact with the baking powder, it causes the baking powder to react with itself and the acids in the recipe. Depending on the recipe, it can be milk, cream, or buttermilk. The steam comes from the cold butter. When it's heated up in the oven, it causes leavening, or pockets of air, to form within the scone and create a flaky, airy texture within it. And then we also do kneading, but we want to keep the kneading of the dough to a minimum to keep it from getting too elastic, which will make the scones chewy and tough. Kneading creates forces that break bonds between randomly aligned strands of gluten in the flour. It stretches those proteins out and aligns them. This whole process is like turning wool into yarn. And this increased structure would be good if we wanted bread. However, scones are very delicate and airy, so you don't want to break those bonds too much. So now let's get into how we actually make these scones. The Starbucks Petite Vanilla Bean Scone. All right, so now we're getting our dry ingredients together. We're doing flour, baking powder, salt, sugar. We're doing half of the vanilla bean seeds, and you're just gonna wanna pulse these together just to get them mixed, you know, kind of thoroughly, so that when you add the butter in, it's already mixed pretty well. So now you're going to cut the butter into pieces and add it into your food processor. You're going to pulse the food processor until the mixture resembles a coarse meal texture. And then once you achieve that texture, you're going to want to add in heavy cream that's also cold like the butter. And also add your vanilla extract, and you're just going to continue to pulse on a low speed until the mixture resembles or comes together in a ball. And then you're going to want to lay it out onto your cutting board or your countertop and just get it all mixed together. All right, so now I'm just putting some flour down so I can kind of shape this into three different little dough balls, but right now I'm just making sure that it's actually all together so that when I do shape it, I'm not just having random pieces that are just still that crumbly meal that we formed before we added in the cream. And so I'm just gonna press it out into, like, I like to make squares, or like the squoval, that square oval shape. Just because that seems to be easier to cut it into the triangular shape. You can do a circle if you want. It's all up to your preference. I just like straight corners, so that's what I like. And these are a little thick, so eventually I'll cut them down. But that's the size of the scones that are made in this recipe. I just like to make them petite because this is a copycat recipe for the Starbucks vanilla bean scone. So I prefer them petite, just preference. You can leave them that size. You just need to bake them a little longer, preferably probably 18 to 20 minutes rather than 12 to 16. Alrighty, so we got our scones nice and I ended up cutting them smaller just because they're petite scones. And I just thought I was making like big people scones and I really wanted them petite. So I cut them, especially this pan had like humongous scones, so I cut them in half. And now we've got about 24, that's how much I make on. Usually my neighbors have their dog outside because they don't love him or her. I think that's Chloe. Yes, I know my neighbor's dog name, but I don't know their names. But I could be a Starbucks employee, like Starbucks, hit me up. I mean, I'm about to get off fellowship, so like, you know, I might need another job. But I think they look phenomenal. We're about to pop these in the oven. Since they're smaller than the recipe that I was using, like the scones that I had before were probably the size that she made. I like mine small because that's how small they are at Starbucks. So I'm going to put them in at 12 minutes, and if they're not done, I will let them go to 15. Last time I let them go for 18 minutes and they were fine, but they were just a little bit browner than the ones at Starbucks. And so I just want them to be a little lighter, just aesthetic really. So that's why. And so yeah, and then I'm also going to clean up and we'll get right into the icing. So now we're going to make the icing. So we're going to use confectioner's sugar, some milk. It doesn't have to be lactose free. We're going to do a little bit of coffee too. They don't really have coffee in them, but I like coffee and I think it'd be a nice addition to this. Sorry. We're also going to have vanilla and vanilla bean extract. And so yeah, let's get started. All right, so now we're on to the icing. You're going to use 1 cup of powdered sugar, 1 1/2 tablespoons of milk. I added in a tablespoon of coffee, and I also added in vanilla bean scraped, the other half. And then we also add in about 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract just because I wanted to make sure that we had vanilla all throughout the icing, not just in the vanilla beans, even though they're so flavorful. I just wanted a little more. And then you just whisk that together. You can use a spoon, a fork, whatever you have. And then I ended up having some more coffee because I wanted some more coffee flavor. And yeah, that's about it. You just whisk it until you get that desired consistency. But make sure you just keep an eye on how much sugar you're adding because powdered sugar is very sweet. So just keep that in mind when you're making this icing. So these are the scones, and they're all done nice and fluffy. Dough is risen. You want that nice golden brown on the bottom with a nice fluffy light color on top. Now let's get ready to ice them. And that is them all iced. They look wonderful.
And I can't wait to eat them.
All I have for you today. Well, actually, for watching this video, you get to try my scones. Yay! The crowd goes wild. Megan's throwing scones. Scones for you. You get a scone. You get a scone. You get a scone. You get a scone. Everybody gets scones. Woo!